began to fight for the rights of their autistic children.
The outlook for Sean Lapin is not good. With help and care and proper education, he could recover and grow into a normal adult. But it's a long shot.
I first met the Lapins in an old documentary John and I had found.
Take Connie and Harvey Lapin, for example. They have a 7-year-old autistic child. They've been running since he was born, looking for help for him.
But I think the autistic child has been the most excluded child in the country.
They told me they could remember the exact day they turned into fighters. It was in 1971, the day they drove their son to Camarillo State Hospital to leave him there. He was 3. It was the same thing Donald's parents had done 34 years earlier.
Can you believe we're doing this? We took a freeway here that never even existed. How many years ago? 40.
And we brought Sean?
Yeah.
47.
47 years ago.
That was the hardest drive I ever took in my life.
The only school for autism in, it's Camarillo State Hospital.
The hospital's been converted into a college campus. But a few of the old psych wards are still sitting there, and they're empty.
So do you remember the day when you drove up here? The sun was shining like today.
We had an appointment.
We had an appointment, and I remember walking in with Sean and Brad and Harvey, and we went right to the children's unit. And we met the director, Dr. Rieger. He took us around, and then he looked at us as a family and said, this is the last place for your child. Go home and figure it out. He saw a family that he felt would be fighters, I think, husband and wife, with resources. I'm glad it looks like. I'm just glad I didn't do it.
The right to get in the door.
The right to education.
Get in school.
I can't emphasize
enough. To give
enough.
Them the right to go to school.
Most schools won't even accept a child like Sean Lapin.
Now we'll count. Ready, begin. 1, 2, 3.
Sean went through 8 programs in 3 years. For each one of them, his mother pounded on a dozen doors and harangued a score of administrators.
When it came out, you weren't supposedly you weren't capable to be educated.
You have autism, you're out.
Yes.
You can't come here. We don't deal with those kind. It's absolutely astounding to me that children with autism did not have the legal right to go to school back in the 60s and 70s. And if it wasn't for the parents that got out there and fought to change that, you know, someone like my son, Mickey, wouldn't have been able to go to school.
Sean became a poster child to say, there's a thing called autism.
They wore picket lines and they raised tons of money.
Well, we want money for research so badly, I can't begin to tell you.
Their lives are passing in front of them. And they went to lawmakers.
Well, they sit on waiting lists.
And it took a long time, but they won.
This year, for the first time, the state of California has ordered that public schools must accept autistic children.
Over the years, they campaigned to get institutions closed for research funding and housing opportunities. And they're still not done. They're almost regulars at the California State House. Still fighting for the rights of people with autism.
I'm here still today at my age 78 because I still have hope. And I won't stop fighting. And I'm hopeful that you will make a safety net that's realistic.
And so Sean, he lives with his brother Brad and some other support staff.
Oh, Sean.
And that support, it's expensive. And they need to know it'll be there when they're gone. That's why they fight. It's love that keeps them and so many other families going. And understand that complicated question. What is autism? What?